So hello everyone. Right now we are just going to start our the tutorial series on the Grasshopper. So you know the Grasshopper is a versatile software where you can do a lot of things. Actually, you know, the best thing that you can do here is on the algorithms. You can make algorithms to design. So the first thing that everyone asks, like what you should know beforehand. Before you want to learn anything. So if you know the basic mathematics like trigonometry and even the multiplication division, if you have even a slight idea, then you can go for the software. And if there will be more things, I will be covering them. And in some places in the advanced course which will come after the beginner course, I will be using even the Python. So there will be some simple Python script, but if there will be the more complexity, I will tell about it. So we will be starting from the basic tools and we will go to the the advanced projects. So this is about the introduction to the Grasshopper, and let's go next. So Grasshopper is actually a visual programming language where you make visual programs to form ultimately a CAD file. So CAD modeling is actually the computer aided design. Anything that you make with a computer software is actually a CAD. Anything actually you design with a computer is actually a CAD modeling. So there are basically three kind of softwares which are used in CAD modeling. So the first one is the solid modeling, and second one is a wireframe modeling, and the third one is actually the surface modeling. So let's go one by one. So before going forward, our aim will be to find out where does the Grasshopper lie. The first one is a solid modeling. So the solid modeling actually work with three-dimensional shapes where you can make primitives like spheres, cubes, and n-sided prism, different kind of the geometries. The best thing about the solid modeling is that it is very fast. There is a very low amount of computational power is required, and you can make strictly very good appearing the models, but there are a few things which we cannot make through it. So let's go forward and let's see what does the next one holds. And the next one is the wireframe modeling is a a little bit trickier than the first one. So the second the softwares like ZBrush and Blender actually use this one. It is actually used to make complex forms, and sculpting kind of things can be done with the wireframe software. The last and the most difficult one is the surface modeling. Surface modeling is you can see it, you are making actually the surfaces which are actually really smooth. So if you want to build a surface which is smooth, you need a lot of points and you have to make a lot of curves to form them. So in the surface modeling there is a huge amount of computation is actually involved that makes it computationally very challenging. So the next thing is, where does the Grasshopper lie? So I won't actually answer the question. I will give you another image. So let's decide. So these are the things that you are seeing right now are actually designed by the Grasshopper algorithms. So if you are going to design these things by the traditional softwares like the solid modeling which includes SolidWorks and SketchUp, or the wireframe, or even the surface modeling, it's gonna take a very long time. If you are making it, it's gonna take a long time. But if you can look at closely, these are actually the mathematical surfaces. You can actually control them by making a particular algorithm. So let's hop into the Rhino and let's see how it looks and user interface. So more details about the user interface and the its component and the other things we will be covering in the next video. So it's just an introduction. So let me open this one. So the thing is, the Grasshopper actually runs over the Rhino CAD software. Right now you can see the Rhino user interface. So let me so if you want to open the Grasshopper, there are actually two ways. The first one is, you can see this little tiny icon right on here, so you just click on it and the Grasshopper will open. So let's wait for it to open. Now you can see the grasshopper is here. Another way to open the grasshopper is let me close it first, is the command window that you can see right down here. You just have to try the grasshopper here and it complete itself, enter, and you have a grasshopper here. So let's see the UI of the grasshopper. Yeah, grasshopper is full of components right now. You can see here there's a parameters, there's a maths, there's a sets, there's a vector, curve, surface, the things which were actually we were using in CAD models, you know, they were actually built-in. But you know, in grasshopper you are going to, you know, build any of your thing from the scratch. So let's see what it have for us. You can go into the geometry, you can see it have 2D curves like circle, curve, plane, rectangle, line, circular arc. These are some basic things which are available here. Primitives are already here, boolean, number, integer, text. And let's go to the maths. You can, you know, use operators, polynomials. We will be covering all of these in the further videos. Sets, vector, and you can even play with the mesh. You can, you know, make your own primitives here. You can see mesh box, mesh plane, even the, you can play with the surfaces analysis and lots of things you can do. And the kangaroo, it's a, you know, physical, it's a plugin which you will have to install externally, which allows you to, you know, work on the simulations and the lunchbox. You can see that this is a, you know, very important plugin which will, I will tell you how to download. You can go to the machine learning, you can even do the machine learning thing in this one, you know, Gaussian mixture, linear regression, neural network. When we will be making, you know, the projects after the tutorials, I'll be using all of these. So we are going to have a lot of fun in this course. And so this is it actually. I will be covering more about the interface and the all of these tools in the further video.